Garden Terror is like a maze. There's paths and bushes everywhere, so you can set traps even behind enemy forts. But on Dragonshire, it's very confrontational and straightforward. So you can only rotate one way from mid to bot and two ways from mid to top. So if the opponent is prudent, they do not get ganked by four. And you will also lose a lot of XP on Dragonshire if you try to do a 1-1-1 split. Are Vikings good on Warhead? I've always thought in theory they are, but it turns out it's not that good either. Because Warhead is, strangely enough, it's a fighting map. It's a 1-on-1 map. Lots of fights. Going around as 4 on Warhead would take ages. And there's not that much to do on Warhead. Like on Garden, if you go for a gank and you fail, you'll take 2 camps as the 4 man. But on Warhead, you get maybe 1 camp. I still think they could work on Warhead, but I haven't seen it enough. I don't know why. Personally, I haven't gravitated towards it yet. Infernal Shrines, they ban Tassadar. I ban what? I'll ban Rag. Do you think a 4-lane map is something we'll see in the future? Could be interesting. It could be. I think we might. It could be really fun.
Victory for the Forsaken.
What do you think of Vikings on Infernal? Used to be very popular about 1.5 years ago, Adelmar. I guess we'll see. I expect them to get Medivh and Anubarak next. Vikings on Infernal. I think it's the objective is a little too strong to ignore, and it's acquired too quickly. The cool thing about Garden of Terror, the objective takes so long to get that Vikings get a lot of value in the time that is lost. But on Infernal, it's fairly fast. So if you keep losing objectives while trying to get XP, it's not going to work well. In fact, I think if you play Vikings on Infernal, you must get Longbow Raid just to help for the team fight. Which support should I ban? Maybe Mouth? I hate Mouth when I'm Kerrigan. Tassadar is already banned, Mighty. Wurin says my highest win rate is tanks and support, but people tell me they are not as impactful. What's your opinion advice? You know yourself best, Wurin. Ignore the general opinion for the rest. Oh.
A light abandons no man.
What the hell is that? Seems good.
Zarya, ready for duty.
This realm needs me.
That's very important to learn.
Jam!
Ashalanore.
Right, I like this draft. We've got Kerrigan, Arthas, Hard Engage, and stuns and slows in control. Zarya, Uther for the support, and Kel'Thas to do some mighty magic fire mayhem. They have a lot of range damage. Cocktail spam, Diablo's Hellfire, Sylvanas' Shadow Dagger, Li Ming's spells, Lucio to heal them all up. They don't have cleanse. We have Kerrigan, they don't have cleanse. Triple backline draft. I mean, Greyman is kind of like a semi-backline.
I need a retreat. This realm will fall before us.
That's the spirit.
What's wrong? Come closer.
I like it.
I have zerglings for that.
Can we see you try TLV on a teamfight map with Longbowed? Gecko? I'm gonna try. TLV teamfight map with Longbowed. I'm going to try for you, okay? Remind me if I forget. Alright guys, enjoy the game. It's Uther, a 2013 hero. I often go Fist of Justice with Uther. This is not one of those games. This is a W or a Conjurer's Pursuit game.
A sound decision.
I go W. I don't like the Conjurer's Pursuit protective shield build. I think it's not good anymore.
The Silver Hand. For the light.
Good timing.
Justice has been delivered.
Out of mana.
I'm going to pull back for now.
Honor guides me.
This music? I would play this at my wedding. Tristram, StarCraft 1 music. Of course, she may not like it, but I think it sounds so awesome. Blizzard, such good music makers. Demolitions expert. My wife wouldn't like it because we're already married, so if I played at my wedding. But I mean, like, wouldn't have liked. Boundless Conviction. Shadow Flare says getting married soon. We'll try to slide these into the playlist behind my future wife's back. That's a great way to start. Do what's important for you. I'm sure it doesn't matter to her.
Ready for action.
She probably won't mind. Baby, what happened to the playlist?
Baby, what happened to your voice?
Oh.
Ouch.
Honor guides me.
I am healed.
You didn't used to have Grubby's impersonation of a female voice.
Strike with great vengeance.
Rip Kel'Thas.
By my honor. I am the
chop it, Uther, chop it real good.
Yeah,
chop it. Do you go convection? Luckily, no.
And he's already got two mana addict stacks in 4 minutes. What's up, where are you going, Diablo? Beacon fangirl? What about Uther Lumberjack? So I have no mana, but I can still soak like a Viking.
I'm going to pull back for now. Very wise.
Yes.
Got him. Cleanse, do we need it?
English, do you speak it?
Diablo's abilities and silence. Holy fire, burn of god. Okay, cleanse.
Whatever it takes.
Whatever it takes. If you take an enemy fort down, do you get more minions? No, but if you take down a fort and a keep in the same lane, then you get more minions. And it's just one extra per wave. It's a catapult. It does splash damage and high damage. It is a kind of win condition to take down one or two or three keeps and then just waste the opponent's time. Eventually, the catapults will push down all the lanes and win the game for you. But it's not overpowering enough that it has no counter. If the opponent is very good at consistent wave clear, they can kind of keep mopping with the tap open, so to speak.
By my honor.
I don't want the tower to die, so I play a bit of dodgeball.
Greetings, friend.
Divine shield?
Whatever.
I knew you could do
it. Heal the one with the most mana. Don't heal Arthas. You know he's gonna Hearthstone soon. That's a waste. Ray Montag. Ray Montag, thank you for subbing. Appreciate it.
I'm going to pull back.
Hey, Anxious 1-4. Yeah, you want to see that Uther game, huh? We really need someone mid.
Agree.
I hate for it to be me. That's the support woes when you know what needs to be done. I mean, I guess it's arguable that it needs to be done. It is arguable, but it's like Sylvanas was here.
Strike with great vengeance.
I guess it is arguable.
Now Valore.
I am shield.
Unfortunately, Kel'Thas walked right into them, drawing the Divine Shield that was meant for Arthas. Sorry, Arthur.
going to pull back for now.
Greetings, friend.
Honor guides me.
Sayek, thank you for the resub. Appreciate the support. 3 months. Welcome back, dude. Thanks for sticking for three. I think they might go here. They are not. Nice scout, but... Come on, guys. Quicker. I wasted my cleanse. Because I thought he was going to cure her, but instead he lightning breathed. It kind of makes my cleanse almost... No, it's not useless. We still have the stun. I'll get Shrink Ray. Shrink Ray is nice on Grey Main, Liming. Not that good on Sylvanas. Hey Grubby, why do you play HOTS? Isn't it just less customizable than League or Dota? I think you'll find that it's not really like that. Less customizable in terms of items, sure. But there's a lot more to HOTS than meets the eye. Not only is it very fun, to the point where you don't even necessarily ask yourself, how hard is this game? Like, is it hard enough? It's very fun, but it's also very strategic and teamwork oriented. And non-stop action. Now, I haven't played Dota 2 and League, and I think they're probably great games. But people that have left those games for Heroes say that they enjoy that Heroes games start from minute one. Rather than the 20-minute laning phase or something. And you know what? For some people, they may think, okay, this Dota 2 too hard or whatever. Possible, I don't know. That's okay too.
Your killing spree is over.
We overstayed in a big way. We just lost the game. Because we were ahead and now we're super behind. We lost the keep now. Kel'Thas can defend by himself, nice. But you know, if he played this different, he just cast a Phoenix. If he did an empowered Gravity Lapse with a Flame Strike and a Chain Bomb, then Phoenix, I think he would have put more pressure on them. But it's fine. We have 5 forts. Yes, tomorrow Warcraft 3, Lee Sin.
By my honor. We should capture this mercenary camp. By my honor.
We're pretty far past the Punisher phase already. We shouldn't all group. We group a little bit too much.
Within the shrine, it will be made to serve us.
The light is with us.
Looking back, I wish we did bottom impalers.
Honor guides me. Honor guides me.
I am the hammer of justice.
We should have had that so bad. I get Gathering Radiance. We still split them though. We should go for Greymane.
We need to take this enemy down.
He's gonna try and kill Kerrigan before he dies.
Consider your flame.
She should be dead. Nice. Very nice, very nice. Now we can get Diablo.
Ready for action.
I have shrink very soon. If I don't get daggered.
Nice try.
Very nice. Very nice saves. You know what? We should go here. If everyone came immediately, but it's fine. We can still get this now.
We should capture this mercenary camp.
For Lord
Arrakis. Fire's on me. Go.
A testament to my glory.
We're still... Oh.
Falling before our Lord and Punisher.
I'm clearly not on the same page. Keep then. Because Sylph is going to, like, push keep or something. Okay, we got keep, great. Don't push it, don't push it.
I am healed.
I must retreat.
The enemy has defeated our Punisher.
Huge minion wave buildups. Huge.
Very wise.
That will give us level 19. And then we'll be right on the way to level 20. Nice checking. They're bruising for a fight right now.
We should capture this mercenary.
The Leaming isn't here, so a fight would have been okay, but.
Strike with great vengeance.
Let's just play it safe. I didn't know or see that properly. They have three bot Leaming. We can actually fight.
I am the hammer of justice. By my honor.
Yeah, we tried.
Much good thanks. I knew that.
This is our riskiest point of the game so far. Okay, good. Nice, nice.
We should capture this mercenary.
They really want to fight. They're just gonna push into the keep, maybe.
Ready. Okay.
Yeah, maybe they are.
You will take it for me.
We should capture this mercenary.
We can afford to split three bot defense, two top. They are three mids, so they're two bot.
For the light.
We see the three not going bot yet. So there's someone down here.
Greetings, friend.
No.
Blinkley.
Oh, nice. If there's... Oh, nice. They didn't come here. They should have come here. All five immediately. Hey, Cabo Chops. Thanks for subbing. We're level 20.
Let's drop
the beam! think it's enough. Oh, the core is dead.
Killing spree.
Huge build-up. There's those catapults that that person asked about. These catas. Try. Okay, let's finish the objective. They're not catapults, they're laser canoes.
That's the way.
Come forth, Punisher. Level the high heavens.
Keep the pressure on.
Keep the pressure on. I wonder where they are. Are they defending behind the wall, or are they trapping us from here? Behind the wall.
Ready for action.
Oh, cocktails.
Honor guides me.
Just need to split yourself as Uther, so you don't get silenced together with the rest of them.
Ready for action.
Keeps probably enough.
I like it.
You are not even trying.
I think this build is actually better than Conjurers and all the other Piano.
MVP.
Yeah, they have a very weird comp because they have no real follow-up for Diablo charging, and it's true. That's why when we draft Arthas Kerrigan in first pulse, they really failed the draft here. They don't have heroes that can fend for themselves. Li Ming tried with Diamond Skin, which I think is a good choice for the situation. But all they have is damage. That's it. Damage, damage and silence, damage. And he's like charging in by himself. And Lucio needs the sound barrier for just Diablo. And he didn't get Apocalypse. So he's like, I got triple damage in my team, but I go for Lightning Breath. And I think he probably needed to do Apocalypse every time. But our draft was solid. Could have dealt with Apoc. In fact, I had almost no use for Cleanse, but Uther's other level 7 aren't that good anyway. By the way, in the rework that they announced for Uther, they said that he is going to get several different ways of cleansing his allies at level 7. Pretty decent amount of healing, actually, with
greetings,
the W build.
Friend.
Thanks for the beautiful Uther game, less than 3.
My pleasure, J. Magio. Really, sincerely, I like this one. He's for a reason my highest level hero. Thanks for the resub. Holy Fire is on level 7 though, I know. And it's pretty good against Sigara, but we weren't against Sigara. When do you like Lucio to go for the reverse amp heroic? I would do that if the opponent doesn't have a bursty team. So like double or triple warrior. And their damage dealers need to be sustained. For example, Gul'dan and or Lunara. I will go reverse amp. Slowing Gul'dan Lunara is great. slowing warriors and damaging them and or damaging them is great. You don't need as much sound barrier burst protect against that. My win ratio in Hero League has been steadily improving. It's 42-37 now, but we were like 20-30. We had a few really bad days. My fault. Bad days, but it's going better. So someone asked if I would play TLV teamfight with Longbout on a map that is not normally intended for Vikings. And we'll see if we can do that. Yes, exactly. Reverse amp still has the positive effects. So it is a slow and a movement speed buff simultaneously. Same with healing and damage. In what situations would you take the other level 10 Uther talent? I did a day or two ago. Let me see. Here. On Sky Temple. We had Li Ming, Uther, Tassadar, Tracer, Mirrodin. So we have two very nice damage dealers. And then they had Illidan. They have triple damage dealer and one of them is Illidan. So I went for the extra lockdown that Divine Storm offers. You can see here there's no real need for Divine Shield. Tracer has enough mobility, as does Li Ming, to escape whatever the other team has. Tracer is actually a bit of a counter to Illidan because he cannot get auto attacks off against her. And Li Ming the same, they both teleport away. Mirrodin is Mirrodin, Tass is Tass, so there was almost no need to de-shield here. There's even a chance that Tassadar shields someone at the same time as I de-shield them, and then some of it will get lost. So this was really a de-storm game. But this was a de-shield game, because we have Kerrigan and Kel'Thas who can get killed. Kel'Thas if he's out of position, Kerrigan if she jumps in. The funny thing is, between the heals of Zarya and me and the shield generation from Kerrigan, we never really needed D-shield. Like, I cast it dutifully when she jumped in with Maelstrom, but she wouldn't have died. That's how much they're competent at work.
The order will rise shortly, heroes. Be ready. You must capture them quickly.
This is a valuable takedown. Not long until they gank me. I think I waited about as long as I was allowed to. Yeah. As long as I was allowed to, and no more. Thank you. Slightly longer than I was allowed to, apparently.